Okay, Wilbur, where are we going to next? 1952. Okay. 1952, we got band roll-on deodorant, which made elevators a lot more pleasant of a place. Rocky Marciano became the world's heavyweight boxing champion, and we needed that because we needed a fellow by the name of Rocky to, as a namesake for those 1970 movies that were so good. The first jet airliner for passengers was put into service, and that was the British Airways Comet. The Colonel gave us Kentucky Fried Chicken, which made it okay for us to lick our fingers in public. Now, I'm not sure I'd shake your hand after that personal hygiene habit was displayed to me, but he made it okay. The Today Show started its run. Movies we went to the movie theater to go see is The African Queen, Singing in the Rain, and The Quiet Man. And we played the Mr. Potato Game back in 1952. And I had to think about that one. This is where my sense of humor comes up. Whoever came up with that had to be on something to make a potato look like a human face. And if you guys want a great joke, do that next time you make baked potatoes for your guests. Okay. And I'm going to have a squirrel moment here, folks. And here's what, I have some special guests in the audience tonight, and I wanted to bring it out tonight. And the squirrel moment's going to be a little bit of a story again. And back in the mid-70s, my sister, my mother, my stepfather at that time, and myself moved out to a small little farming community known as Flint, Texas. It was east of El Paso by about 30 miles, and it's close to the border of Mexico. And like most farming communities, it had a lot of poor people. It had people that are well-to-do. And it was about the size of Sadler. And where I went to high school had about 200 kids in it. And my graduating class was 38, so you can imagine about the size of Sadler, that sort of thing. But what happened there was absolutely incredible. And the reason why is the school board there was excellent. And they really, really had a strong desire to have a top quality education for every single student that went through the school system, regardless of their background, regardless of any other pre-existing condition. They hired several very good teachers, but one in particular that made a huge difference in my life and a huge difference in many other individuals' lives came from a server out of El Paso as a band director. And he came in, actually I think he was trained as a mathematician, and had background in the United States Army as well. But what he did was incredible. And not only did he do it, but also his wife, who went through hell and back to support him on this, because it certainly wasn't for the money. What happened is through his hard work and his love and his dedication, and I'm including him and his wife in that, love and dedication for the students and what they did was absolutely phenomenal. And it's an example for us all. What occurred because of that is he took this music, this little town who had a small band, a small, you know, high school band, and made them into one of the best, if not the best in the state back in the mid-70s all the way up through the mid-1980s through the seeds that he planted. He did it through hard work, coming in early, leaving late at night, coming in and working with the kids weekends, working with them individually in sectionals and the band. And he taught the kids something incredible. And here's the fruit of the labors for the kids. Many of them went on to become, there's an organization known as the Texas Music Educators Association, and many of them went on to earn Allstate, which back then, every school, regardless of the size of school, competed against each other. Didn't matter. So you know, Clint was 200 kids, you would go against schools out in Fort Worth or in Dallas of maybe 5,000 kids. Well, many of those kids made Texas an all-state band under that. Also, the music ensemble, as it was put together through hard work and through, you know, that dedication, went out to compete at the highest levels in the state of Texas and win against schools that were massively larger. I like that. And when I was talking to him recently, and he had made a comment and said, jokingly, around the state, it became known as the conservatory on that, you know, as far as that. But it culminated in 1978 when Flint High School won the Texas State Honor Band. I like that. And then it was awarded every 2 years. You had to skip the next go-around, and then they won it again, so they won it consecutively. Now, that was remarkable in its own right. But what also, you know, as goofy teenagers, we did not understand necessarily what was going on. You know, as teenagers, we're sitting there going, hey, this is great. We can go out and compete with anybody. We can win. It's a lot of fun to go on these trips. Didn't really realize what was happening at that point. And what was happening, you know, was that we are learning to rely on ourselves through hard work. We're learning to rely on our bandmates because of their hard work. We are learning to believe in a mission. We are learning all these different things that people, that kids get out of music education, being involved in an organization. Okay? To us, it was all fun and games. These life lessons came later. And many of those individuals that were in those music ensembles back then have gone on to do absolutely great things. Absolutely great things. And, you know, it was because of that seed that was planted back in Clinton. Try not to get choked up. In any case, that individual and his wife are in this audience tonight. They're actually neighbors of ours. He just completed his 50th year of music education at Howell Middle School. And he retired this year. And I'd like to ask Mr. Michael Marsh and his wife, Elaine Marsh, please to stand. Ever repay the countless lives that he's touched and done in a keenest way, because, like I said, it's a prayer, and they went through, trust me, hell and back. I'd also like to say, do I have any educators or teachers, both past or present, in the audience tonight? Would you please stand, ma'am? And anybody else, please stand? Like that? Please, like that. I want to let you guys know, you know, like what I just related to you as stories and so forth like that. You know, today's education system is difficult enough because you've got pressures all different ways. And sometimes you can't see the forest because of the trees. But what you do truly does make a difference. You are planting seeds that eventually will absolutely come to fruition and better someone else's life. So, folks, please give our educators and teachers a hand. Again, thank you very much. And guys, enjoy. This next song is dedicated to you as educators, and it's Unforgiven. Thank you. You're very, very kind. Thank you. Thank you again to all you teachers and educators. We truly are very grateful for your service.